啊，经历了好几年的新冠疫情啊，又受到俄乌战争等很多很多因素的影响，2023年的前景到底如何呢？
After several years of the COVID and the Russia-Ukraine war, what will happen in 2023?
啊，我看到有一些的报道哈，表达了一些专家，还有一些的民众啊，他们对2023年世界的经济局势表达的一种担忧。
Some reports show that scholars and ordinary people are worried about the economic prospects in 2023.
啊，很多人关心经济的问题，是因为经济问题直接影响到我们的生活。
Many people are concerned about the economy because it directly affects our lives.
啊，但是我们基督徒不应该只是关心经济而已。
However, as Christians, we should not just be concerned about the economy.
啊，我们还应该更关心信仰、道德和法律。
And we should be more concerned about religion, morality, and law.
因为上帝通过道德和秩序，在这个世界赐给人普遍的恩典。
God gives people common grace through the order of morality and law in the world.
上帝更是通过基督成就的救恩，赐给信靠他的人救赎的恩典。
God gives believers the saving grace through the redemption which was accomplished by Jesus.
啊，但是当人们放弃了对耶稣基督的信仰，也拒绝上帝的普遍启示，那么道德一定会堕落，法律迟早会失去。
When people do not trust God and abandon the general revelation of God, morality will inevitably degenerate. Sooner or later, the lawlessness will come.
所以作为基督徒，我们要戴上圣经真理的这个眼镜，我们先会看到，其实我们已经处在一个属灵荒凉的一个时代了。
As Christians, we can see through the lens of the biblical truth, the spiritual desolation in our eyes.
今天我们的处境跟先知哈该时代的处境其实有几分的相似。
Our situation is somehow similar to that of the prophet Haggai.
啊，在公元前587年啊，巴比伦就攻陷了耶路撒冷。
In 587 BC, Babylon captured Jerusalem.
巴比伦人就毁坏并且洗劫了所罗门时期建造的那个圣殿，并且把很多犹大的百姓都俘虏到了巴比伦。
The Babylonians destroyed and looted the temple which was built during Solomon's time and took the people of Judah captive to Babylon.
啊，后来巴比伦帝国被波斯帝国所取代。
Later, the Babylonian Empire was taken over by the Persian Empire.
在以色列人掳巴比伦70年之后，波斯王古利就允许以色列人回到耶路撒冷去重新建造圣殿。
70 years after the Israelites were exiled in Babylon, King Cyrus of Persia allowed the Israelites to return to Jerusalem to rebuild the temple.
但是当时回到耶路撒冷的以色列人，大概只有4万多人。
At the time, only about 40,000 Israelites returned.
其实更多的以色列人是没有回归的。
More Israelites didn't.
更多的以色列人选择继续留在外邦人的土地上生活。
More Israelites continue to stay in the land of Gentiles.
他们不愿意放弃经营多年的产业，回到耶路撒冷建圣殿。
They were unwilling to give up the properties that they had managed for years.
因为那样做的话，付出的代价太大了。
Because it would have cost them too much.
啊，所以更多的人没有回去建圣殿。
So the more people didn't go back to rebuild the temple.
啊，但是圣经里呢，重点记载了那些回到耶路撒冷建圣殿的人的事情。
The Bible here focuses on the rebuilding of the temple by those who actually returned to Jerusalem.
啊，所以我们对这一批回归的人的印象比较深刻。
Therefore, we are more impressed by this group of returnees.
啊，但是这一批回归的人并不是以色列的绝大多数。
However, this group was not the majority of the Israelites at the time.
从回归的人数的这个比例上来看，当时以色列人的信仰整体上是比较荒凉。
So from the ratio of returnees, the faith of Israel is declining as a whole.
而在这一批回归者的当中呢，又有很多人逐渐失去了建造圣殿的热情。
Among this group of returnees, many had lost their enthusiasm for building the temple.
他们遇到一些困难以后就心灰意冷。
And they were discouraged when facing difficulties.
他们去建造自己的房子，而不再关心圣殿的建设。
And they went to build their own houses and no longer cared about the building of the temple.
这就是为什么在哈该书的一开头，先知就责备以色列的百姓，就说了那句我们都很熟悉的话，说这殿仍然荒凉，你们还自己住天花板的房屋吗？
That's why in the beginning of the Haggai, the book of Haggai, the prophet rebuked these people and said, Is it a time for you yourself to be living in your paneled houses while the house remains a ruin?
然后在哈该书的一章十节到十一节，就是告诉我们说，神让以色列人在耶路撒冷经历了干旱之灾，他们土地荒凉，当时民生凋敝。
That's why chapter 1 verse 10 to 11 shows us that God brought a drought to Israelites in Jerusalem. The land was barren and the quality of life has decreased.
这既反映了一种经济上的荒凉，也反映了信仰上的。
It is not only economic desolation, but also the spiritual desolation.
好，那接下来还剩一部分人，这更少的一批人，他们呢，回到了耶路撒冷，仍然一直在关心圣殿的建设。
There were a group of people, when they returned to Jerusalem, they cared about the temple.
对于这一批圣殿的以色列人来说，他们的眼前也是一片荒凉。
For them, what they saw is a desolate scene.
在哈该书第二章第三节说，你们中间存留的，有谁见过这殿从前的荣耀呢？现在你们看着如何？岂不是眼中看如无有吗？
Chapter 2 verse 3 says,Who of you is left who saw this house in its former glory? How does it look to you now? Does it not seem to you like nothing?
所罗门时代的那种繁华的国度的景象早已经一去不返了。
The prosperity of Solomon was gone long time ago.
辉煌的圣殿已经变成了断壁残垣。
The glorious temple has become ruins.
而圣殿象征着上帝在他子民当中的居所。
And the temple symbolized God's dwelling place among his people.
所以当时以色列人的这种信仰的衰落，导致这个圣殿的建筑，事实上就算存在也是名存实亡。
When the Israelites failed to believe in God, the temple building only exists in name.
在以西结书里面我们就看到神的荣耀离开了圣殿。
In the book of Ezekiel, the glory of God left the temple.
圣殿的被毁是以色列人信仰衰败的一个结果。
The destruction of the temple was the result of their turning away from God.
而通过圣殿的荒凉，我们可以见证以色列人信仰的衰败。
The desolation of the temple testified for the spiritual desolation of Israelites.
那这是哈该所处的那个荒凉的时代，就跟我们今天所处的这一个年代几分相似之处。
Haggai's desolate age is somehow like ours.
今天在欧洲有很多历史悠久的基督教的教堂，早都已经变成了购物商场，有一些变成了清真寺。
Today in Europe, some historic church buildings have been turned into shopping malls or mosques.
在美国很多的老龄化的现象非常的明显。
In the U.S., the aging of the congregations in many churches is very obvious.
那年轻一代人的当中，基督徒的比例急剧的下降。
Among the younger generation, the percentage of Christians have dropped dramatically.
在中国，在穆斯林的国家，在朝鲜，在一些佛教的国家，很多的基督徒和教会正在经历着逼迫。
In China, North Korea, Muslim countries and Buddhism countries, Christians and the church are suffering brutal persecutions.
当然我们从个人的层面来说呢，的确有一些基督徒个人在经历一些属灵的。
Although many individual Christians are having spiritual revivals.
某一些地方的教会可能也会经历一段时间的这个教会内部的复兴。
Maybe in some places, churches are experiencing spiritual revivals.
但是从整个宏观的时代背景来看，整体而言，我们处在一个属灵荒凉的时代。
However, from the big picture point of view, we live in a spiritual desolate age.
18世纪到20世纪初，在英国，在美国都经历过属灵大复兴。
From the 18th century to the beginning of the 20th century, there were great spiritual awakenings in Britain and US.
很多很多的宣教士从英国或者美国前往到中国和其他地方去宣教。
Many missionaries traveled from England or America to China or other countries.
在1930年代，其实在中国也经历过属灵大复兴。
In the 1930s, there were also a spiritual revival in mainland China.
在20世纪初的时候，在英国威尔士一场属灵大复兴的当中啊，只有一个地方，那个地方没有人去看戏了。
During the great spiritual revival in Wales in the early 20th century, there was a place where nobody went to theaters.
那些戏院一家一家的都关门。
The theaters had to be closed.
因为人们都去参加布道会去了。
Because everybody went to the evangelical meeting.
后来连布道会在那个地方也办不下去了。为什么呢？因为所有的人都已经悔改信主了。
Later, no more evangelical meeting because all the people there had repented and believed in Jesus.
我们没有生在那个年代。
And we were not born at the time.
我们没有见过那个时代属灵复兴的那个场面。
We didn't see the spiritual awakening with our own eyes.
那是一个什么样的场面呢？
What does it look like?
我们想一想，几个星期之前卡塔尔的世界杯的比赛哈，你大概可以想象出历史上教会属灵复兴的场景。
Let's recall the FIFA World Cup, in December.
如果很多人把在世界杯上的那种热情用在福音的事情上，那将是一场属灵的大复兴。
If people put the same enthusiasm on the gospel, there would be a spiritual revival.
可惜我们这个时代从整体上而言啊，基督徒新的热情远远比不上当年复兴的时代。
Unfortunately, generally speaking, Christians' enthusiasm for the gospel today is far less than that of the awakening time.
但是，不要因此而感到消沉。
But please do not lose heart.
我们来看哈该书第二章第四节。
Let's look at verse 4.
耶和华说：“所罗巴伯啊，虽然如此，你当刚强。”
Verse 4 says, "But now be strong, Zerubbabel," declares the Lord.
再说一次，这句话很重要。虽然如此，你当刚强。
Let's say it again because it's important. But now be strong.
虽然这是一个荒凉的时代，但是我们仍然应该刚强壮胆，竭力的为主做工。
It is a desolate age, but be strong, work diligently for the Lord.
现实可能令人悲观，但是悲观不等于被动，悲观不等于消极。
The reality seems despairing, but it doesn't mean that we need to be passive or negative.
无论现状如何，我们总应该积极的去建造教会。
Despite of the reality, we need to actively build the church.
我们对基督的再来的盼望总应该是活泼的。
We always have the living hope for Christ's second return.
我们对天国的热情总应该一直是高涨的。
We always have enthusiasm for the kingdom of heaven.
这应该是我们进入2023年的时候应该有的态度。
This is the attitude we need to hold for 2023.
在哈该书里面，神呼召所罗巴伯、约书亚和剩下的百姓刚强做工，建造圣殿。
In the book of Haggai, God called Zerubbabel, Joshua, and the remnant of the people to be strong and build the temple.
所以在任何一个时代，你就看到上帝为他自己保守一些忠心的子民。
So in any time, you can see God always keeps the faithful people for himself.
在旧约时代，以色列时代有一个时期是属灵非常黑暗的。
There is a time in Old Testament it was very dark spiritually.
是谁做王的时代呢？
Who was the king?
亚哈的时代。
The king was Ahab.
在亚哈的时代，上帝为他自己保守了多少个不向巴利屈膝的人？七千个不向巴利屈膝的人。
In his time, God had reserved 7,000 whose knees have not bowed to Baal.
那么在哈该的时代，同样上帝为自己保守一些忠心的子民，让他们殷勤的去建造圣殿。
At the time of Haggai, God also reserved faithful people for himself and asked them to faithfully build the temple.
今天2023年，上帝同样为他自己在这个时代保守一些忠心的子民，呼召他们积极的去建造教会。
In the same way, in 2023, God reserved the faithful people for himself and caused them to actively build the church.
无论是在哪里，不管是在中国，在美国，在非洲，在欧洲，任何一个地方，上帝的工作从来没有停止。
No matter in China, US, Africa, Europe, anywhere, God's work has never been stopping.
如果说在18世纪啊，北美大陆上的那个属灵的大复兴的时代， 神的工作就好像是地震，就好像烈火一样啊，令人感到震撼。
If we say that God's work was as shocking as earthquakes and raging fires in the Great Awakenings in America in the 18th century,
那么在今天这个时代，上帝的工作像什么样的一种形式呢？
So in today's time, what was God's work like?
我们引用旧约圣经的一段经文描述这样的一个光景。
Let's quote from one passage from Old Testament.
在今天这样一个属灵荒凉的时代，上帝在教会中复兴的作为，不在地震中，在地震后有火，耶和华也不在火焰中，火后有微小的声音。
In today's desolate age, God's work is are neither earthquake nor raging fire. After the earthquake came a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire came a gentle whisper.
这一段话让你想到谁？
What does this verse remind you of?
不，谁让你想到谁？这就是先知以利亚所在的那个时代经历到上帝的作为。
Elijah.
在这个属灵荒凉的时代，上帝的声音是这个时代的主旋律，而是主旋律背后的微小的声音。
In this spiritual desolation, the voice of God is not the mainstream voice.But a gentle whisper.
但是这种微小的声音证明了上帝与我们同在。
And yet this gentle whisper proves that God is with us.
所以为什么在这样一个荒凉的时代，我们仍然要刚强的为主做工呢？第一个理由就是因为上帝仍然与我们同在。
Why do we work courageously for the Lord in the age of desolation? The first reason is that God is with us.
第四节说，你们都当刚强做工，因我与你们同在。这是万军之耶和华。
Verse 4 says, Work, for I am with you, declares the Lord Almighty.
在哈该的时代，上帝对那少数回归的以色列人说话。
In Haggai's time, God spoke to a small number of returning Israelites.
上帝与他们同在。
God was with them.
今天在这个新约的时代，上帝也对他的儿女说话。
Today, in the time of New Testament,God speaks to his own children.
上帝与他的教会同在。
God is with his church.
有圣灵在我们的里面。
Holy Spirit dwells in us.
有耶稣基督做我们教会的元首。
Jesus Christ is the head of the church.
神在2023年与我们的同在，就跟神在哈该的时代与他的子民同在是一样的真实。
The presence of God is as real in 2023 as it was in Haggai's time.
所以不管这个年代的光景如何，我们可以大胆的为主做工，不需要有任何的胆怯。
So no matter what, we don't have to be afraid and work diligently for the Lord.
第一个刚强做工的理由是神与我们同在。
So the first reason to work diligently is that God is with us.
第二个理由是我们相信神是信实的。
Second reason is that we believe in God's faithfulness.
第五节说，这是照着你们出埃及与我与你们立约的话，那时我的灵住在你们中间，你们不要惧怕。
Verse 5 says, This is what I have covenanted with you when you came out of Egypt, and my spirit remains among you. Do not fear.
神与以色列人立约的时候所说的应许，一句都不会落空，都会实现。
The promise God made when he covenanted with the Israelites will surely be fulfilled.
神的话语一句都不会落空。
Every one of God's words will be fulfilled.
对于我们新约时代的基督徒来说，上帝也与我们立约。
For us, as New Testament Christians, God has made a new covenant with us.
上帝不会废弃他在新约里面给我们的应许。
God will not void the promise.Of the new covenant.
他应许我们在基督里罪得赦免。
He promised that our sins are forgiven in Christ.
所以我们可以坦然无惧地来到他施恩的座前，来寻求勇气，寻求智慧。
That's why we can approach the throne of grace with confidence to receive the courage to receive the wisdom.
然后可以大胆地走进你的社区，走进你的办公室里面，去彰显神的荣耀。
And then boldly walk into your community, walk into your office to reflect the glory of God.
神应许他会赐给我们永恒的产业。
He promised us an eternal inheritance.
所以我们就更加的确信这世界非我家。
That's why we are more convinced that this world is not our home.
所以我们就更无需去眷恋这个世界上的一些荣誉、舒适和安全。
So we don't need to be entangled with the honor, comfort, and security offered by the world.
因为就像保罗所说的，这些东西与基督相比，就如同是粪土一样。
Just as Paul said, compared with Christ, these things are just like rubbish.
所以我们不害怕失去这些东西。That's
why we are not afraid of losing them.
所以当你不害怕失去这些东西的时候，你就更勇敢。When
we are not afraid, we are more courageous.
在荒凉的时代里，刚强的为主做工。第三个理由是我们相信神的主权。The
third reason that we work diligently in the desolate age is that we believe in the sovereignty of God.
我们看第六节到第八节，万军之耶和华如此说：过不多时，我必再一次震动天地、沧海与旱地，我必震动万国，万国的珍宝都必运来，我就使这殿满了荣耀。这是万军之耶和华说的。 万军之耶和华说：“银子是我的，金子也是我的。”Verse 6 to 8
says, "This is what the Lord Almighty says: In a little while, I will once more shake the heavens and the earth, the sea and the dry land. I will shake all nations, and what is desired by all nations will come, and I will fill this house with glory," says the Lord Almighty. "The silver is mine, and the gold is mine," declares the Lord Almighty.
上帝是掌管天地万有的主。
Our Father rules over the heavens and the earth.
他可以震动天地，还有其中所有的受造之物。He
can shake the heavens and the earth and all creatures in them.
上帝可以有能力震动万国。He
has the power to shake all nations.
尽管很多国家的人不认识上帝，很多的人反叛上帝，但是所有的人都在上帝的掌管之下。Even
though people in many places don't know God and many people rebel against Him. All of them are under God's control.
没有任何一个人，没有任何一个君王或者任何一个民族能够颠覆上帝的主权。No
individual, no king, no nation can undermine God's sovereignty.
相反，上帝可以轻而易举地废掉一个君王或者颠覆一个朝代。On
the contrary, God can easily abolish a king and overthrow a dynasty.
上帝可以叫万事互相效力来成就他的旨。
God can cause all things to work together to accomplish His purpose.
在哈该书的这段经文里，上帝说他会叫万国的珍宝都运到耶路撒冷，用来建造圣殿。In
the passage, God says He will make the treasures of all nations brought to Jerusalem to build the temple.
因为上帝才是这些珍宝的主。Because
God is the real owner of the treasures.
上帝可以随意的调度这些资源。
God can dispatch the resources for His own purpose.
上帝也可以调动人的心思意念，使用人的手，使用人的决定来分配这些物质资源，来成就他建造圣殿的旨意。God
can also control human thoughts and use human hands to allocate the resources to accomplish His will to build the temple.
在耶路撒冷的周围有很多的外邦的民族和国家。
There are many Gentile nations around the city of Jerusalem.
这些国家里面很多很多的物质的财富都会聚集到耶路撒冷来。
And all the treasures from all these surrounding nations will come to Jerusalem.
这是谁的工作呢？
Whose work is it?
这是上帝的作为。
This is the work of God.
是上帝激动人的心，让人能够献出这些财宝。
That is God's work. He compels people's heart to give the treasures to Jerusalem.
要来做什么呢?
What is the purpose?
目的是什么?
What is the purpose?
用这些财宝来建造什么? 建造圣殿。
To build the holy temple.
也就是在那一个地域的当中，有一个地方是上帝工作的中心。
So we can see that in that area, God's word, there is a place where God works.
那就是耶路撒冷的圣殿，这是中心。That
is the holy temple in Jerusalem. This is the center.
其他的那些外邦国家那些物质的资源，那一些的因素，都是围着耶路撒冷的圣殿来服务的。All
the resources of all the Gentiles work together for God's purpose.
但是今天这个圣殿建筑已经从地球上消失了。
However, the temple building had disappeared already.
可是哈该书的这段经文体现的属灵的原则是永远不改变。
However, the spiritual principle expressed in this passage remains the same.
上帝仍然在掌管万国万民。
God is still in control of all nations.
今天上帝工作的中心不再是那个物质的圣殿，而是他的教会。
The core of God's word is not just a physical holy temple, but the church.
正如哈该的时代，上帝是通过统管世上的万国来建造他的圣殿一样，今天上帝是通过统管万国万民来祝福他的教会。
In Haggai's time, God would build up the temple through his ruling over all nations. In the same way, today, God blesses his church by ruling over all nations.
以弗所书一章二十二节说，神又将万有伏在基督的脚下，使基督为教会做万有之首。
Ephesians chapter 1 verse 22, and God placed all things under his feet and appointed him to be head over everything for the church.
基督做万有之首。
Christ is the head over everything.
万有都伏在基督的脚下。
All things are placed under the feet of Christ.
基督掌管万有。
Christ is in control of everything.
但是他为什么要掌管万有呢？
Why does the Christ do that?
他掌管万有的目的是什么？
What is the purpose?
是为了什么？
For what reason?
为了什么？为教会。
For church.
为教会，基督做了万有之首。
For the church, Jesus Christ has been appointed to be head over everything.
教会才是基督工作的目的。
The church is the purpose of God's work.
教会是中心。
The church is the center.
万有都伏在基督的脚下。
Everything is placed under the feet of Christ.
万有，包括世上的国家的政权，包括瘟疫，包括战争，包括和平，等等，这一切都伏在基督的主权之下。
All things, including the governments, COVID, wars, or peace, are placed under the feet of Christ.
基督掌管万有。
Christ is in control of everything.
基督掌管这个世界里面的一切。
Christ controls everything in the world.
但是基督掌管万有的目的是什么呢？
And what is the purpose of Christ ruling over all things?
是建造他的教会。
In order to build his church.
是为了教会。
For his church,
教会是基督工作的目的。
The church is the purpose of Christ's work.
而世界里面的万有是基督手中的工具，用来祝福他的教会。
And everything in the world is Christ's instrument to bless his church.
再说一次啊，世界里面的这些万有在基督的手里只是一个工具，是用来祝福他的教会。
Let's say it again.Everything in the world is an instrument of Christ in order to bless his church.
在历史上，上帝在某些国家里兴起过属灵的大复兴，是为了让这些教会可以差派更多的宣教士，把福音传到更多的地方。
In the past, God caused spiritual awakenings in some nations so that more missionaries were sent by church to more places.
这样的话，更多的教会就会被建立起来。
In this way, more church can be built.
在有一些地方，上帝也允许某一些的国家的政权逼迫教会。
In some places, God allowed certain governments to persecute the church.
但是在这种环境里，上帝可以使用这种环境来炼净他的教会。
And through these circumstances, God refines his own church.
当新冠疫情剥夺人的健康的时候，耶稣基督可以保守他救赎的人信心变得更加的纯粹和坚固。
When COVID has threatened people's health, Jesus has kept the faith of his redeemed people purer and stronger.
基督是万有的主宰。
Christ is Lord of all.
基督掌管万有是为了建造他的教会。
Christ rules over everything in order to build up his church.
谁会下象棋？
Who can play chess?
你不一定要下的技术很高，你懂一些基本的规则都行啊。中国象棋也行，国际象棋也行，会吗？很多人都懂象棋，对吗？
Chinese chess or the other kind of chess.
你会发现中国象棋跟国际象棋有一些相似之处。
the Chinese chess is very similar to the international chess.
所以你想象，你脑子中想象中国象棋也好，想象国际象棋也好，你都可以，我们接下来都可以想象同样一个原则。
So let's just imagine, it doesn't matter whether you think of Chinese chess or the international chess.
象棋当中有很多的棋子。
There are many pieces in chess game.
哪一个棋子最重要的？
What piece is the most important?
Lucy, 哪一个棋子？ The king, right? 将，在中国象棋里叫将，或者叫帅。
The king is the most important piece.
将是整盘棋当中的那个主角。
The king is the main character in the whole chess.
其他的棋子全是配角。
The other pieces are just the supporting character.
整个的世界好像一盘象棋。
The whole world is like a chess game.
在这一盘象棋的当中，那个将或者那个帅，就如同是谁？ 教会。
So the king in the chess game is like a church.
教会就如同是象棋当中那个将。
The church is like the king in the chess game.
这个世界里面其他的一切，就好像那个卒、那个马、那个炮等等，就是在基督的手中，这些世界上其他的棋子都是来为教会服务的。
Everything else in the world is like pawns, bishops, knights, rooks, queens, moved by God's hand to serve the church.
所以我们就更应该刚强壮胆。
Therefore, we need to be stronger.
因为耶稣基督掌管全局。
Because our Lord Jesus is in control.
而且耶稣基督注定会得胜的。
And Jesus Christ is destined to win.
因为他已经借着死和第三天的复活战胜了仇敌。
Because he has already defeated the enemy through death and resurrection.
当基督第二次降临的时候，他最后一招定乾坤。
When he comes again, he will make the last move to checkmate his opponent.
相信吗？
Do you believe that?
这个世界最终会过去，但是耶稣基督的教会会永远长存。
The world, the current world will pass away, but the church of Christ will endure forever.
所以我们在一个属灵荒凉的时代，不用惧怕，而刚强的去传播福音，去实践信仰。Therefore,
we don't need to fear in the desolate age, but be strong to share the gospel and lift out our faith.
我们再来看第九节。 第九节说：“这殿后来的荣耀必大过先前的荣耀，在这地方我必赐平安。”这是万军之耶和华说的。Verse
9: The glory of this present house will be greater than the glory of the former house, and in this place I will grant peace, says the Lord Almighty.
在所罗巴伯还有以斯拉等人的带领下，有一些以色列人回去重建了圣殿。Under
the leadership of Zerubbabel and Ezra, the remnant of Israelites rebuilt the temple.
这个圣殿被称为是第二圣殿。This
temple is the second temple.
第一个圣殿是谁主导下建立的呢？
And who built the first temple?
所罗门时代建立的。Solomon. 但是呢，第二个圣殿呢，后来到了公元到了主权19年的时候，大希律王主持扩建，整修了那个第二圣殿。In
19 BC, Herod the Great renovated and expanded the second temple.
但是第九节这里说，后来这个殿呢，后来的荣耀必大过先前的荣耀。那这一节经文还主要是指着他属灵的荣耀来说的。In
verse 9, the glory of the present house will be greater than the glory of the former house, mainly refers to the spiritual glory of the temple.
因为当主耶稣基督道成肉身来到世上的时候，耶稣就亲自的站在那个圣殿里。
When Jesus came to the world, he stood in the temple in person.
当主耶稣站在那个圣殿里的时候，那个圣殿的荣耀就超过了所罗门时代建的那个第一个圣殿的荣耀。When
he stood in the temple, the glory of the temple was greater than the glory of the first temple.
因为神的儿子耶稣基督亲自的站立在这个圣殿里。Because
Jesus Christ, the Son of God, stood in the temple.
但是当基督第一次来到世上的时候，虽然他进入了圣殿。 但是还没有完全的实现哈该书的这一节的预言。However,
Jesus' entry to the temple did not fully fulfill the prophecy in verse 9.
因为当时耶稣基督的荣耀还没有完全的彰显出来。Because
the glory of Jesus was not completely manifested at the time.
而且这一节经文预言说神必赐平安但是耶稣基督进入圣殿的时候 其实没有带来平安，反而带来了一场冲突。
Also, Jesus' entry to the temple did not bring peace, but conflict instead.
耶稣基督进入到圣殿，做了一件什么事儿？
What did Jesus do when he entered the temple?
他是来砸场子的，把那些兑换银钱的人的这个摊子都给掀了。
He was making trouble. He overthrew the tables of money changers.
我们说圣殿其实只是一个象征。
The temple is just a symbol.
它象征着神与人同在的这个居所。
It symbolizes that God dwells with His people.
而这样属灵的意义，其实是借着耶稣基督道成肉身，得以最直观的一种表达。
The spiritual meaning is most directly expressed through the incarnation of Jesus.
啊，在约翰福音一章，说道成了肉身，住在我们中间。
John chapter 1 verse 14 says, "The Word became flesh and made His dwelling among us."
啊，住这个希腊文的单词，它就是搭帐篷的意思。
The word dwell, the Greek word dwell, means setting up a tabernacle.
搭帐篷。
Setting up the tabernacle.
在启示录第七章十五节有一节经文说，做宝座的要用帐幕遮蔽他们。
Revelation 7:15 says, "He who sits on the throne will spread his tabernacle over them."
用帐幕遮蔽，词跟前面说的那个住那个词其实同一个词。
Here, spread his tabernacle over is the same word as dwell.
帐幕，这让我们想到在旧约时代以色列人的那个会幕。
This word reminds us of the tabernacle in the Old Testament.
在旷野的时候，那个时候没有圣殿。
In the wilderness, there was no temple.
用什么来象征神与以色列民同在的那个居所呢？
What was used to symbolize the dwelling place of God?
那个时候是用什么？
What was it?
那个会幕。
Which is, it is tabernacle.
所以会幕和圣殿都表达了同样一个属灵的意义。
So the tabernacle and the temple express the same spiritual meaning.
这个属灵的意义都指向了谁？耶稣基督。
They both point to Jesus Christ.
在约翰福音第二章，当主耶稣进入到圣殿里，掀翻了那个兑换银钱的人的桌子之后，他就说了一句话。
In chapter 2 of John,Jesus said something after he turned over the table of money changers.
他说：“你们拆毁这殿，我三日内要再把它建起来。”接下来圣经说：“因为耶稣说这话是以他的身体为殿而说的。”
He said, "Destroy this temple, and I will raise it again in 3 days." But the temple he had spoken of was his body.
当主耶稣来到世上的那个时代啊，那个圣殿的确也挺壮观的。
In Jesus' time, the temple appeared to be magnificent.
你还记得有几个人，几个门徒看到那个圣殿的时候叹为观止。
Do you remember the disciples were amazed when they saw the temple?
但是在耶稣基督的眼里，那个圣殿已经没有荣耀了。
However, in the eyes of Jesus, that temple was not glorious.
因为当人们没有了敬虔的信仰。那个圣殿也就名存实亡了。
Because the people didn't have faith, the temple exists in name only.
但是耶稣要建立起一个真正荣耀的圣殿。
However, Jesus wanted to build a glorious temple.
这个圣殿不是用砖头石头建立起来。
This temple is not made from bricks.
这个圣殿是用人来建立起来的。
This temple is made of people.
是用他所救用他的宝血买赎的人建立起来的。
Made from people who are redeemed by his precious blood.
这是一个属灵的圣殿。
This is a spiritual temple.
这就是他的教会。
This is his church.
教会也被称为是基督的身体。
The church is also called the body of Christ.
哥林多前书三章十七节说，因为神的殿是圣的，这殿就是你们。
1 Corinthians chapter 3:17. For God's temple is sacred, and you together are that temple.
我们这一群被基督救赎的人组成的教会，就是一个无形的属灵的圣殿。
The church is composed of us, a group of people redeemed by Jesus Christ. It is an invisible spiritual temple.
教会有基督做元首。
Christ is the head of the church.
教会有圣灵的同在。
The Christ has the presence of the Spirit.
而父神要在教会里，在基督里来彰显他的荣耀。
And God the Father reveals His glory in the church and in Christ.
啊，在这里我们要稍微区分一下无形教会和有形教会的这个概念。
Here we need to distinguish between the invisible church and visible church.
来一个神学考试啊。
Now let's give a theological test.
啊，谁可以简单的总结一下什么叫无形教会？
Who can summarize what is the invisible church?
无形教，对，无形教会是什么？如何来描述什么是无形教会？
Please describe the invisible church.
对，历世历代所有的信徒组成的这样一个集合。
So the invisible church is a collection of all believers from all ages.
我们现在看不见这个教会，因为这是一个超越时间和空间的一个所有时代的所有地方的那个信徒组成的这样一个群体。
This is the invisible church because it is a collection of believers from all ages, surpassing space or time.
但是今天在每一个地方，某一个具体的地方的这个教会是有形的教会。
So the specific physical churches on earth are the visible churches.
比如说我们杰克逊华人教会就是一个有形教会。
For example, the CCCGJ is a visible church.
为什么它是有形的呢？
Why is it a visible church?
因为你看得见嘛。
Because you can see it.
你看得见我们这一群具体的人。
You can see us, a group of people.
你也会看得见这一个敬拜的具体的地点和形式。
And you can see the building.
但是我们当中每一个重生得救的基督徒同时也都属于那个无形教会。
However, every born again Christian here also belongs to the invisible church.
所以弟兄姊妹，你是属于杰克逊华人教会这个具体的有形教会。
So brothers and sisters, you belong to the visible church, CCCGJ.
但同时你也属于那个无形教会。
At the same time, you belong to the invisible church.
但是当基督再来的时候，我们和历世历代所有的信徒共同组成的那个无形的教会，要像新娘一样被基督迎娶到天上。
When Jesus returns, the invisible church, composed of all the believers of all ages, including us, as a bride, will be received by Jesus in heaven.
Amen.
Amen.
这是我们的盼望。
This is our hope.
到那一天，杰克逊华人基督教会就已经不存在了。
At that day, CCCGJ no longer exists.
但是杰克逊华人基督教会装备过的信徒仍然是无形教会的一部分。
But believers who have been equipped by CCCGJ are still a part of the invisible church.
所以地上的有形教会是在为无形教会来预备信徒。
Therefore, the visible churches on earth are equipping believers for the invisible church.
我们再重复一次这句话很重要。地上的无形教会是在为地上的有形的教会是在为无形的教会装备信徒。
Let's say it again. The visible churches on earth are equipping believers for the invisible church.
无形教会充满了荣耀。
The invisible church is full of glory.
但是地上的有形教会应该把无形教会的某些荣耀的特征在这个地上给彰显出来。
And the visible church on earth need to manifest some of the glories of the invisible church.
所以我们如果真的渴慕耶稣基督再来的时候进那个完美的无形教会的话，我们就应该积极的去建造地上有形的教会。
Therefore, if we desire to enter the perfect invisible church when Jesus returns, we need to actively build a visible church on earth.
当然，地上的有形教会是有残缺的。
Of course, our visible church is not perfect.
但是这一个现实并不能够否定无形教会是完美的。
But it doesn't negate the perfection of the invisible church.
所以我们应该预备迎接那将来的荣耀。
Therefore, we need to prepare for the glory to come.
当基督再来的时候，完美的无形教会要进入神永远的荣耀。
When he comes again, the perfect invisible church will enter God's glory.
到那一天，教会的荣耀要大过历史上任何一个时代属灵大复兴时的荣耀。
That day, the glory of the church on will be greater than glory of any great awakening in history.
到那一天，无形教会所彰显的荣耀是圆满的。
And the glory of the invisible church is perfect.
在启示录二十一章第二节第三节说，我又看见圣城新耶路撒冷由神那里从天而降，预备好了，就如同新妇装饰整齐，等候丈夫。我听见有大声音从宝座出来说，看哪，神的帐幕在人间，他要与人同住，他们要做他的子民，他神要亲自与他们同在，做他们的神。
Revelation 21 verse 2 to 3, I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God.Prepared as a bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, Look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God.
新耶路撒冷所代表的就是完美的无形教会。
The New Jerusalem represents the perfect invisible church.
就像一个完美的圣城一样从天降临。
It is like the perfect holy city descending from heaven.
而这个圣城和圣殿一样，代表了神与人同住的居所。
This holy city, like the holy temple, represents God dwelling among His people.
然后在启示录二十一章二十二节说：“我未见城内有殿，因为主神全能者和羔羊为城的殿。”
Verse 22 says, I didn't see a temple in the city because the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb are its temple.
在将来的新天新地里还有圣殿吗？
Is there the temple in the new heaven and new earth?
使徒约翰在这个意象中看到这个新耶路撒冷没有殿了，没有圣殿了。
And there is no temple in the new heaven and new earth.
为什么？
Why is that?
因为我们的神他亲自做我们的殿。
Because God, our Lord, is the temple.
在完美的新天新地里，不需要再用一个有形的圣殿来代表神的同在了。
In the perfect new heaven and new earth, there is no need for a visible temple to represent God's presence.
因为神与人同在这个事实是以最直接的方式来实现的，是充分的，是完美的，不需要再代表了。
Because God's presence with His people is intimate, sufficient, and perfect.
这是我们最后要最终的归属。
This is our ultimate home.
进入无形教会，永远的与神同在。
Enter the invisible church, be with God forever.
但是无形教会里面的信徒是从哪里塑造出来的呢？
However, what is the training ground for the saints of the invisible church?
从哪里？
Where is the training ground?
从哪里？是从地上的每一个有形教会里塑造出来。
Yes, from the every visible church on earth.
就像我们刚才说的，地上的有形的教会发挥的一个很重要的功能，就是为将来在天上的无形教会装备圣徒。
Just like we said, one of the functions of the visible church on earth is to equip the saints for the invisible church in heaven.
所以，如果我们渴慕进入那天上的新耶路撒冷，我们就应该。投身于地上的无形教会。
If we desire
地上的有形教会
to enter the heavenly New Jerusalem, we must commit ourselves to the church on earth.
所以在2023年，盼望我们能够带着很积极的态度建造神的教会。
Therefore, in this new year, we should actively build up the church.
在2023年，我们的心里面应该充满盼望。
We need to be full of hope.
无论这个世界上发生什么。我们最终都将进入那荣耀的圣城。
No matter what will happen in the world, we will enter the glorious holy city.
即使2023年的经济会衰退。
In 2023, there might be a recession.
或者我们2023年也会经历一些人生的幸福时刻。
Maybe in this new year, there might be happy moments.
或者在2023年你会事业有成。
Or have career achievement.
或者你会有一些人生的喜讯。
Or have good news.
但是所有这一切都只是你人生当中的配角。
However, all of these are just supporting characters in your life story.
在耶稣基督的手中，我们人生当中所有的这些痛苦的或者幸福的遭遇，都是为了让我们能够得着那永恒的荣耀。
Happiness or sorrow in God's hand all serve for your glory, your eternal glory.
如果你的人生就像一盘象棋的话，
if your life is like a chess game,
谁是那个将是指的什么？
Who is the king?
教会，教会就像你的人生的一盘棋里面的那个将。
The church is like the king.
谁是你这一盘棋人生的这一盘棋的这个操盘手？
Who is the chess player?
是谁？耶稣基督是你人生的操盘手。
Jesus Christ is the chess player.
2023年，我们虽然跟世人一样会经历同样的社会环境。
In 2023, we may face the same life circumstances.
但是我们不像世人一样，只是为了寻找世界上的安全感而忙碌或者焦虑。
However, we are not as restless or anxious as the world.
我们可以把更多的情感、时间和精力用在神的教会上。
We can spend more time and energy in the church.
因为世界是配角，教会是主角。
Because the world is the supporting character and the church is the main character.
上帝掌管这个世界的局势，是为了成就他的教会。
God controls the world events to build up his church.
所以当经济形势令人担忧的时候，
So when the economic situation is worrying,
当国际政治动荡不安的时候，
When global politics are turbulent,
我们却刚强壮胆，
And we are strong.
想一想哈该时代那些建造圣殿的人，
Think of the people who built the temple in the time of Haggai.
想一想尼希米时代建造城墙的那些人。
Think of the people who built the wall of the Jerusalem in the time of Nehemiah.
他们虽然也面对仇敌的威胁，
And they faced the threat of the enemy.
但是他们怎么做呢？
When what did they do?
他们一手拿兵器，一手为主做工。
And they held weapons in one hand and worked for the Lord with the other hand.
愿我们也能刚强壮胆地迎接2023年。
Let's fearlessly welcome the new year.
在逼迫中成长。
And grow in the midst of persecutions.
在荒凉中勇敢。
And be brave in desolation time.
保护神的教会，建造神的教会。
And protect God's church and build God's church.
盼望这一年2023年是我们属灵复兴的一年。
We pray that this new year, 2023, become a year of our spiritual revival.